Hello guys, I am Riot, Tyrant Riot, and this is the 6th video from the series Watching 1600 Players. So, let's go. Let's take a look. Today I'm gonna watch Panna Cotta against Small Girl from Vietnam. It's a Hans War, and before watching the game, I wanna take a look on the map. So, I will open here a file, which is this one, and here you can see the whole map, and let's take a look what's going on over here. So this is Panna Cotta, the green guy which I am looking, the wreck, and this is the enemy. So we have here gold in the back, and also gold kind in the back, a good wood from the enemy, a good wood for him as well here and here. So pretty fair map. Pretty even. Also, you have one extra gold for Panna Cotta and one extra gold for the enemy. So, pretty fair map. What we can take a look over here and see what's important. If you check over here, you see a big, big, big hill. And with this hill, you can have access to this gold from the enemy, and the enemy can have access to this gold from you. So I think the key of this game is taking a good control of this hill over here. In late games, also you can check another important hills, which is around here, where you can have stone and one extra gold, and also over here, where you have a stone, a good hill, you can make a castle over here and protect your enemy from raiding you from here. And also, you probably gonna have this wood over here safe, and then a lot of farms and meal over here. Okay, guys? So, important hill, very important hill, and another important hill. You can raid from here, you can raid from here, and also you need to focus your main army on this hill over here. So that's it, guys. Let's go to the game now. Just saying again, it's Hans War, and let's go fast in the beginning because I don't think we should waste too much time in the Dark Age. Let me just put the volume a bit lower, okay? So far so good. We put 4 villagers on wood, we lost one view here. Okay, he's up. The enemy is gonna lose his scout. No, no. He barely lose it. 3 HP. It's fine. Barracks. You get the barracks up in time, I think. Let's see what enemy is doing. Enemy is taking gold, probably going man at arms. Yes, he's going man at arms. And also sending 3 villagers forward. Let's take a look. 4 man at arms rush with villagers to do some towers and maybe archers. Let's see. Okay, the enemy knows. Panna Cotta knows already. So he's defending himself. Nice wall over here. He's already doing a tower, pretty early in the game, but it's okay. Nice wall, nice defense. He's going scouts. Now he'll try to attack and do some damage. Oh, look the tower from the enemy, man. Look how much these villagers, those 3 villagers walk from the map, because look where he's blue. He's in the edge of the map, and look where they went. Oh, this is amazing. Anyway, let's keep watching. Nice. He got one villager. He might take one more. Nice, 2 villager. So he's already ahead, 2 villagers. You can see the count over here. Now, he needs to care about this. He could have walled here, maybe. Maybe there wasn't time to do that, but if he walls the enemy here, then he knows that he lost 4 men-at-arms. But it's hard to do that. Let's go fast. So, as you see, 6 villagers ahead, guys. 6 villagers ahead. And also, the enemy has 3 villagers not working, because the villagers went since the beginning of the follow up time to here, and it's not taking any resource. So big advantage for the green player over here. Now, one thing that I don't like too much is the number of villagers in the goat. 15 and 50 minutes and you have 10 villagers on goat, which is huge. You don't need that much. You could have like 4 or 5, and then the next 2 goes there, and 7 or 8 is fine to do archers with. 8 is better, actually. So too much villagers here. So you know that your economy is not that well balanced. See? Nice fight for him here. So 11 more pop for him, 6 more villagers, 6 military against 1. So, very nice advantage for him so far. He's doing archers. New lumber camp. And you see, as I said, already 444 gold. So it's too much, too early, and there's no reason for that. The enemy is doing scouts now. You got one more villager? No, not this time. Okay, 2 archers, blacksmith, and now the enemy is here. And the enemy is doing bloodlines, so this is gonna hurt, guys. He's coming back with scouts. He had no protection there. He saw the stable, but he didn't make any unit, any spear here to save those villagers. Now he lost 1, 2, I think 1 more. Let's see. 3 villagers. And maybe 4 now. Let's take a look. No, 3 villagers. Okay, this is huge already. You see that the count villager is just 2 now, and it was 6 earlier. He keeps looting archers, which is good. 500 gold for nothing. You see? Now he has 6. Oh, now it's good, now it's good. He made fletching, he's going to attack with the archers. And guys, when you get hurt villagers like this, and it's far from your TC, remember to take, look, at least this and this and this, and make farms with them. Remember to took them close to your TC, okay? So if the enemy comes again, it's gonna be so easy for him to kill those villagers. Let's see if he has bloodline. Oh my god, he doesn't have wheelbarrow yet. 21 minutes, he should have wheelbarrow already. So, one more point here. No wheelbarrow. And now a good place to leave the archers over here. And now he sees that the enemy is going to attack. Also, you can see, always remember to look when you see enemy's army, to click on one of them, and you can check the upgrades from the enemy. So you see that he has bloodlines and defense, so he most likely going for a scout full scout field strategy. So you really need to care. Okay, he's doing spears, which is good. He could send those 6 archers to here, it helps defend. And now he's going up. Let's see. Yeah, he's up. But he's up without wheelbarrow. Remember, this is not too good, guys. You can go castle age without wheelbarrow, but if you are going for a fast castle, So you can go without wheelbarrow, but if you are doing a 23 minutes up castaways without wheelbarrow, you need to know that your economy is not gonna be so great. Okay, he's being attacked over here. Also here. He needs to care, he can't lose too much villagers now. Also guys, one hint here. You see, he most likely gonna lose all of his archers because the enemy has a lot of scouts and with all upgrades. So one hint, if you are close to the next age and you know that you can upgrade your army, take care of your army. Don't waste them. He could stay here for a bit more and or even go back with the army to defend himself. But instead he tried to attack, and let's see what's gonna happen here. He has 10 archers. Remember this. 10 archers. And he's losing everything. He got one villager. 10 archers for one villager, which is a huge loss. And if he tried to protect them, leaving them here, now in Castaways, which is almost there, he could have 10 X-Bows. And 10 X-Bows is much more stronger to kill those scouts. So a big mistake from here, from him here. Okay, 4 archeries, and the economy is a mess, guys. No barrel. He made crossbow and broken arrow. Now let's see what's going to happen. I'm gonna go a bit faster. And guys, you see here, what is his problem? I think when he see the enemy's army, he goes all of his army in one side and forget about the other side. He should, or he should try to wall here, from here to here, and maybe here to here, and leave all the army here so he knows he's protected, or at least try to wall these villagers, which is hard, I know, but you can wall those villagers with palisades, and then you can leave your army just in one side. But now let's take a look. You're gonna lose more and more villagers, more and more villagers. Okay, he went to the attack, but let's take a look. No defense upgrade. And not too much army. He has 11 here. Remember, if he gets together those 11 and also those 10 archers, it would be 21. 21 here, my friend. 21 X-Bows here. Trust me, it's over for the enemy. Or even here. You see that the enemy even walled here because he knows that archers over here, it's pretty much over for his wood. So don't forget those 10 archers wasted there. Now he's losing everything for blue. I'm not sure if he has. Yeah, he doesn't have wheelbarrow yet. This is bad. 30 minutes and no wheelbarrow yet, so not too good, not too good. He's going to do a siege workshop to kill this tower. Not sure if worth it, maybe yes, maybe not. Let's take a look here. Okay, he's upgrading Pikeman. He made 2 barracks, which is okay, not bad. And now he's going to attack with CA and Pikeman. Okay, now look this. He could have went here for the gold. The enemy doesn't have tower in the gold because he made a tower here. He doesn't have stone, I think. Let's take a look. He doesn't have stone, but instead he's killing one palisade here. Now the enemy walled, and he could be here attacking a lot of farms and taking the gold, but instead he's doing nothing there. And meanwhile, blue is killing his villagers. Oh, great. One more thing, guys. You see this town center? Do you think it does it worth? Because there's two piles left. Actually, there's one because this is almost over. It's like one with 800 gold. So
Timo.
I think a better TC would be here, or maybe here to kill this tower. I don't know, because now, because then you can take this gold, and there's eight piles here without being touched. Now you're gonna see why it doesn't worth to do this TC. I will show you later. Now finally he's going to this spot after wasting a lot of time here, and let's see what he's gonna do here. Idle villagers. He's mad with his CA. Okay, he needs to make one more TC around this wood, maybe. Okay, now he's trapped. You remember? He could attack here when the enemy was here without his army. Now he's gonna lose everything and not too much damage. Finally, wheelbarrow. 34 minutes. No, my friend. No. Too late. Too late. He's making villagers 1 TC, but the other one is not working, it seems. It was a really waste of wood. Two villagers here. Two villagers. Two villagers. Okay. 30 TC. Finally. Still no bloodlines. No defense. Oh, just. Anyway, let's go. Beat, beat. Okay, the enemy's castle just now. Almost 40 minutes, guys. This is really late. Okay, he's doing bloodlines now, but the enemy is upgrading light cavalry and also elite skirmisher. So, let's see. But he doesn't have too much elite skirmisher yet, so. Not too bad for green. Not too bad. Let's see. Look, the enemy doesn't have plus two in the elite skirmisher, so he can make. He can stay here, no problem. Now look this TC. Remember what I said? You have to send all your villagers here. Look how much they have to walk
Timo.
before work. So this is really bad. Anyway, he's getting closer in this part. You see that the number of villagers is. He's now ahead, even though he lost a lot of villagers. But the blue player, he took too much time to go castle age. That's why he's ahead now. Three town centers, let's see blue. Only one town center. Doing town center. 40 minutes with one villager, guys. Look how much reserves. And he's doing one town center with one villager. Whoa. This is not good. Okay. University. Do farms here, my friend. Do farms. Make it better. Okay, what I think he should do now. He has a lot of army already. You see? It's a lot more than 30, I think. And he doesn't have something to attack. I mean, he made Sieg Workshop here. He could have done two mangonels here with all of his army and do a lot of damage here or here. So I don't know. He's not attacking too well, I think. One more TC, which I think is okay. It's not that bad, but he can't forget to make the hunt card. He can't. Okay. He's doing a good flood of army, you see? Every time I look, he's doing army, so I'm saying something good from you here, Panacotta. Not only bad things. Finally, farms here. But he took villages from wood to make farms here. Look, the villagers went from the TC to the wood and then
Timo.
to wood from TC. Look how much waste time, man. Look. Okay. The enemy is raiding him. Light cavalry. He has a lot of farm, guys. Look. But now he's not doing anything. No villagers, no army. No villagers. Finally, villagers. Okay. He's going to attack. Let's see. Look, if he had a mangonel over here. Look, one or two mangonels would be so great attack. But no mangonels, not too good. He made one more stable. I don't know why. It seems that the enemy already has ballistic. That's why it killed it so easy. So he has to care. He needs mangonel or something to kill those skirmishers. He can't waste CA. Remember, don't forget to do handcart, guys. Almost 50 minutes and no handcart yet. Okay, he made plus 2. It seems he's gonna stay in this fight. Which is not the best idea in my opinion. Well, it's still okay. Not the best, but it's still okay. But now, take a look on this. Okay, guys, take a look on this. Oh my god. Oh my god. And he's being attacked over here. And he's losing here. And losing villagers here. And losing army here. And losing villager here. And losing army. And look at the Villa Count. 10 different. And he's losing villager. And losing army. What the hell? What are you doing? Oh, he made some knights. But he's losing villagers still. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, this is so bad. Okay, he lost. He might lose. It cost the game, I think, here. Really bad. He lost a lot of villagers here, and he lost almost all of his army for skirmishers. He didn't have knights yet, he didn't have mangonels to support the CA. So he lost almost everything, and also he lost a lot of villagers. Look, look. Oh, now he made something. I think light cavalry, but he had almost 800 food and no wheelbarrow, guys. No wheelbarrow. Let's check. Let's just. If it's 13. Yeah.
He delivered.
He delivers at 13 food, so no handcart yet. This is bad. This is really bad. And now he's doing 2 seed workshops after the heal. When the heal ends, and there's no reason. Do it over here. Do some breedings on the heal, and then your army is gonna be here. But here, there's no reason to do that. Take a look on enemy's economy. He's flooding a lot of villagers. He's almost 200 population. And this is looking good for him. He's stonewalled as well. Just playing safe now. And now the cast. Okay, guys. So let's go back a bit. Let's go back a bit. How he could have done better. First thing, wheelbarrow was too late. Second thing, he could have done the handcart much earlier. Third thing, he should take stone earlier, I think, and made this castle even earlier with mangonels. Mangonel CA, and maybe he didn't even need it to make knights and light cavalry. Because if he didn't make that, and if he had the handcart, he could have be up now with the castle up over here, and he could be up imperial just like the enemy is, and also he could have the control of the hill. But now he might even have the control of the hill, but he's not even close to the imp, and the enemy is going to the imp. So for the enemy to kill this castle is really easy. And he's gonna fight this, which is, I'm not so sure if it's a good idea. It Castle is up as well. He's losing a lot of army without any reason. And now it's looking not too good, guys. Not too good. I'm waiting for him to make handcart. Finally, guys. Finally, finally. Handcart. But now the enemy is Imperial. And now for him to take this castle is really easy. Because you have stronger units, you have trebuchets, you have runs. And also it seems that the enemy has a really good economy. So it's looking really bad for him. He's doing dumbring just now, which is late as well. Why this? One more TC? Why? You don't need 5 TCs with 1 hour of game and no imp. You don't need that. Okay, he's finally up, but now 2 trebuchets attacking the castle, and he's only 30% up. So he's gonna lose that castle, he's gonna lose the hill, and the enemy, as I said in the beginning, will have control of this huge hill over here, which takes control of this gold. In my opinion, what he could do now, because he's losing really, really big. You can see in this card, it's more than 3,000, sorry. And then, what he, in my opinion, he should do now. I think he should focus on trying to go to the sides and trying to do hussars. Maybe forget about CA. I think the enemy has the hill, the enemy has rams and skirmishers. So I think the good idea here would be trying to boom and to go to the sides, forget about the hill from now, trying to raid from here to there. I know it's walled, but you can do Sieg workshops closer. Try to raid from here to there and trying to gather units to attack the hill later. That's my opinion, but it is pretty over the game already, guys. Just some thoughts that I think that people would like to know about what to do in this occasion. Look, the enemy has Sieg run already, which is huge. Even though the enemy doesn't have too much army. Okay, his army is here. Because I don't see much here, but yeah, he does have a good number. 200 pop. The hill advantage. Man, imagine, how can you win this hill back now? You just can't, my friend. It's really hard. Okay, he's having a good fight here. But I don't know where is the enemy army. Let's see. Oh, it's here. Okay. Something there. He's flooding more. Making more stables. He has hussar upgrade. And now he's also taking control of this hill, which is very important. Remember in the beginning I said this is the most important hill, and this one is very important as well, just like this one. So the enemy has the control of the map now, which is very important. Okay, he's trying to do a lot of stables. I'm not sure if he has enough farms. If he has enough farms, just 29, he doesn't have. Don't even do 10 stables if you have 30 farms, guys. You need to have at least 50, 55 farms if you want to do 10 stables. Actually, 14 stables, you see it over here? So, it's more a waste of time of villagers wasting. He could have made farms over here, boom, in the side. This is pretty much over, guys. I'm gonna go faster now because there isn't much to do over here. He's doing farms now. He has all of upgrades, but no hussar yet. And the enemy is playing really good. If you wanna learn good positions from castle, this is good position. This is also good position, and also this one is good. Maybe a fourth one here, which is very good as well, and the enemy has the control of the game, pretty much. He's doing paladin now, when he shows the paladin, I think it's gonna be easy. Yeah. GG called. Even, I mean, he didn't call yet. But it was GG, over already. Well, let's just point some things. Wheelbarrow too late. Second thing, which he may have cost the game, is that he lost 10 archers over here in the field when he could have 21 X-Bows if he get together the army. So that was a really bad choice from him. Also, he didn't make a good push in the castaway here. He was better in the castaway in the beginning because he had more villages and more army. But only CA against skirmishers do nothing. But if he attacked earlier with Siege Workshop here, Mangonels, CA, and then a castle over here with 3 town centers or maybe 4, but if you do 4, don't forget, or even 3, don't forget the handcart. He could have done Mangonels, CA, and then go Imperial really, really earlier than he did. So he lost the game. Also, don't forget about that time that he lost all of his army here without any reason, and he lost a lot of villagers. I think it was here, there was a wood here. So he could have won this game, even though a lot of mistakes. Okay, guys, that's
the wonder,
it for today.
The wonder that no
one new follower, and thanks for watching. See you later.